In this question, we are given a paragraph and then a question is asked. Here it says the wave property of electron implies that they will show diffraction effects. Davison and Germer demonstrated this by diffracting electrons from the crystals. The law governing the diffraction from a crystal is obtained by requiring that electron waves reflected from the planes of atoms in a crystal interfere constructively. Yeah, the figure is shown, and in Davison-Germer experiment we already discussed the same. These are the three layers of atoms. One incoming electron wave is reflected from the top layer and then from the bottom layer. We first find out the path difference in the two waves, and in this situation the outgoing electrons, so when these will interfere outside, according to the path difference between the two waves, they'll either interfere constructively or destructively. So first, if we talk about the path difference here, we can say if there's a wave A going as A dash, B going as B dash. If we consider A is reflected from a point O and B is reflected from a point O dash, then we can see path difference in the electron beam which are electron beams which are diffracted from points O and O dash R. If we talk about this wave, it is going directly, the other one is traveling a path, this path extra. So if this distance is D, this angle is I, here we can consider this angle is also I. So this path difference, this is the extra path which is traveled by the wave B before incidence at point O dash, and the same is the path which is traveled by the path traveled by the wave after reflection from point O dash. And this can be written as d cos I and d cos I. So in this situation here, we can say the path difference between the two waves can be given as delta is equals to 2d cos I. And we can say for constructive interference, in the two beams which are considered as waves, we use, here we can write path difference is 2d cos I, and this should be equals to n lambda, where n belongs to set of integers. That's the condition for constructive interference. Now when we talk about the wavelength of the electron beam, that can be obtained by de Broglie's hypothesis. So we can write wavelength of electron wave is given as, here we can write lambda is equals to h over momentum as mv, which we can write as h over root of 2mk, and the kinetic energy of electron beam which is accelerated by potential difference v is 2mev. Here we can write as kinetic energy is EV because the electron beam is accelerated with the potential difference V. So here we can write 2D cos I is equals to N times H by root 2MEV. If we calculate the potential difference here, V can be given as, it is N square H square by, this is 8MED square cos square I. And we are required to calculate the value of V, for which D is taken as 1 angstrom, I is taken as 30 degree. So we need to calculate the potential difference at which constructive interference will take place. So there are several values here we can say. For least value of V, here we take N is equals to 1, and correspondingly the value of V we are getting is H square by 8 me d square cos square I, and we can substitute the values of h, m, e, and d I. So here h will take as 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 34 whole square divided by 8. Mass is given to us as 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31. E is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 16. And D is 1 angstrom, so it is 10 to the power minus 10 whole square. And I is taken as 30 degrees, so cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So here it is root 3 by 2 whole square. I'm just leaving calculation part for you. You can calculate the final result we'll be getting is approximately 50 volt, which matches with the option B here. So answer to this question will consider as option B.